Well, hello there, crazy people. We are going to do something really, 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 really interesting, or at least I think it is. I'm going to install Microsoft Windows Server 2022, I think it's called, Evolution. This can you can download this for free. You just have to fill out a form that says who you are and give your fucking email address and shit like that. And then you can download it, and it can run for 180 days. And I think you can extend it all the way up to about a year, more than a year, maybe even longer than that. But I've heard people using it for a year. So if you are not know nothing about, if you don't know much about Windows Server, it's a good idea to download it that way, and you know, get familiar with Windows Server. If you are a Linux person that wants to learn more about how Microsoft actually are doing their server editions, you can download this and get the knowledge for yourself and not just believe everything that all those pesky people out there are telling you about Windows and Microsoft. You can experience the horror yourself. You can experience the downfalls yourself. You can experience the slow-ass updates for yourself. You can experience all of the bad things. Or you may also experience a lot of good things. It's not always bad things. But you get first-hand experience. So if you are a Linux user, Linux content creator, or something like that, and you want to critique something, you need to know something about it. So that's why I'm installing Microsoft Windows Server, because I want to critique it. I want to be negative about it. I want to yell at it. But I also want to, well, basically, I want to compare to how Linux is doing it on that side. So why not go in here and go nuts? So install language, we'll just keep US English, time and currency format. Let's just keep it US English. It don't matter that much. I, however, want to change it into the good old Danish keyboard. There it is. We click next. And of course, you can repair your computer or you can click install now. I will say I actually like this installation process. If you know how to install Windows, you can install Windows Server. So we have Windows Server 2022 Standard Evolution. And this is the option for most Windows. This option omits most of the Windows graphical environments managed with the command prompt and PowerShell or remotely via Windows Admin Center. This is basically a headless server. If you do the desktop environment, which is the one we are going to do, we are going to get a fancy desktop. It's also going to take more resources. Then we have the data center, kind of expenses for the big data centers and stuff like that. But here's the thing, if you are at home, I will say that one of these two will probably be your choice. If you're setting up a file server or something like that, you'll probably go with standard evaluation. Dyslexia like a motherfucker. I can't read. Evaluation. We are going to do the desktop one because we want a graphic interface, because we are newbies like that. This is probably also the one that if you have one server at home, you'll probably go with it. Let's say you have like two or three servers that you want to do different things with, in like you may have a firewall and stuff that you all want to based on Windows. You could have one server be your admin server with a desktop environment and then install all the rest of them in a headless state. Or install all of them and then, you know, use, what is it called? Windows Admin Center to log into it. But anyway, talking like a fucking idiot. Let's click next here. You need a virtual, I'm doing this in virtual machines, in VirtualBox. You need a virtualizing software that can utilize TPM and Secure Boot, by the way. I have read the license. So here, upgrade, let we all, like I said, I normally want to do the upgrade stuff. So I just want to delete all of these because I actually tested it out, the headless version. So this would be what you will experience. I allocated 50 gigabytes, click new, click apply, and it's setting up automatically the partitions. We'll say this is way more convenient than doing under Linux. Some Linux installers can set this up for you by yourself. Other Linux installer, you have to go in and be the fucking system administrator and do all of these pesky things of slicing off the partition. And there's pros and cons to everything. You can also do this in here yourself. You can go in here and you can, you know, slice and dice the drives as much as you can under Linux. So it's not like you have to do this all automatically. We can go in and do all kind of crazy things. See, we can expand it, format it. If it's a different format, we can load drive, we can refresh. Anyway, you get the idea. let's click next. So now what it's basically just doing is, oh, it's not prompting us for a password and stuff like that. You do that when it's installed. So right now we just have to wait for it to finish, and then we can get to it in there. And we are back. It actually didn't take that long. It needs to restart. Let's just restart now. It didn't eject its the ISO. Well, now we're booting up. And there will be updates we have to do. I don't want to show you guys the update process because it's slow. I will do that. And then later on, we can probably do some other stuff with Windows Server. If you guys want me to do some shit in there, we can do that, of course. So it's rebooting again. The setting up almost took longer than the install did. So a little tip when you don't know what's going on with a computer. I'm not saying this is the case. You can see it's doing stuff. But if you think that your computer has frozen or halted or nothing is going on and you're like, oh my God, I need to, you know, press the reset button and stuff like that. When you get to that point, wait at least 10 minutes longer. Set your watch for like 5 to 10 minutes. Chillax, go get a coffee, because it may do shit in the back and you don't know about. I don't know how many times I'm about to walk up and restart my computer and then something happens. So when you get to the point where you're fed up, 5-10 minutes timer, chillax, go for a walk and see if things happen. So good old administrator. So now we need to actually set up the password. And I think it's not, we can't just do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't think we can do that, can we? No. Some Linux servers have this also implemented, that you can use weak passwords. Some don't. So let's see if you can do this. Oh, that's also, oh, that's okay. Gotcha. So it's actually set to really strong passwords. There you go. So I had to put a character in it. So here it is. And you may say, oh my God, we can't get it to work because we need to press Control Alt Delete or Alt Delete. And if you're on the Windows as your host system, or sometimes even Linux, and you do that, it basically wants to lock you out and stuff like that. So if you're on a virtual machine, there's actually something called Input Keyboard. And here, Insert Control Alt Delete Alt Delete. And there's a host plus del delete button where you basically are telling, you know, the environment, the virtual machine, that I just pressed those buttons even though you didn't do it. So let's go in forward here. And here we have it. It's starting up services. Do you want to allow PCs to discover this by, yeah, let's just make it discoverable. We don't really care that much. So here we can get more info about the Windows Administrating Center if you want to. In here we can see all the services and what have you not. And this whole service manager desk board. It's actually really, we can see the local servers we have in here. There are already some warnings, time servers, probably because the localization don't match all my servers. This is the server I'm running right now. File and storage in here is actually where we can set it up as a file server, which I'm thinking, debating about to do. But let's go back here into dashboard. There are some alerts here, I think. So if you click here on services, we see clickboard used, Edge update, so we need to update Edge. All services we have, again, probably because we need to update the system, we are getting these here. But this is how fast and how easy it is to install Windows 2022 server. Let's see if I can actually set this up to 1080p, by the way. I can't. Let's keep it here. I need to install the VirtualBox editions to get full-blown resolution. And again, you can see down here, 180 days. Like I said, I've heard people being able to extend it to 1 or 2 years, I can't remember, just by extending the evaluation time. And it looks a lot like Windows 10. It's basically Windows 10. Just taking out a lot of the stuff that's not needed for a server and hardening it to some extent, doing a lot of stuff to make it more server-esque. So there's probably not Xbox in here. If you go in here and we type Xbox, you know, there's no Xbox game app. There's no optimization for gaming. Is there even HDR? No. I don't even know if you can enable HDR in display settings. If you go in here, we have Windows HD colors. Advanced display settings. Yeah, I don't... Graphical settings, is that maybe it? No, I think, you know, you may be able to enable it if you have a, you know, proper graphic card drive and stuff like that. We do have tablet mode for some reason, which I find really, really interesting. We have multitasking in here, you know, so we can do stuff like that. But as you can see here, all of the fancy shit with the, you know, moving windows while we are dragging it around, you know, auto-refreshing the windows while they are moving. This is like something we did in like XP or Windows 95, is that we got this box here. Why? Because it limited resources. It don't take so many resources. You don't need that big of beefy hardware if you don't have to render the windows every time you move them. You just basically take a box and then tell the system, render now the window here. You're not rendering it all the time here. So there's all these crazy things that they're doing with Windows Server that they're not doing with the proper, the desktop version of Windows or the workstation version of Windows, because this is focused on one thing being as great as possible or as slimlined as possible. If you go in here into the good old task manager and we do more details, you see I'm running at 1%, I'm using 1.5 megabytes or gigabytes of RAM. Yeah, I gave it 8 gigs of RAM, you're using 1.4. But if you start to open up, you know, let's say Edge here, you can see now the CPU and the memory starts to creep up. And now we are looking at Linux numbers. This is kind of what Ubuntu installed takes up with Firefox open. We are close to the 2 gigabytes. That said, this is not the desktop version of Windows, but Ubuntu is the desktop version of Ubuntu. So it is to some extent impressing thing that Linux uses out of the bat, or not uses, but utilizing RAM in a different way than Windows does, which is a really, really interesting thing that we have to remember, is that not all operating systems are utilizing RAM in the same way. So you can't just sit and say, oh, it's using more or less. You can go and do a lot of things here. I've seen people playing games. I've seen people, I heard about people, you know, installing Steam and play their games on the Windows server and say it's better than under Windows 11 and 10. I don't know, it's not something I want to try out. But we could go in and do a lot of amazing, crazy shit in here right now. So it's basically just up to you people what you want to see. I'm now going to update the system because there's more than likely a shit ton of updates in here. Oh, I'm actually having it open, that's why it's not doing it. So we go into Home. Where is updates? There it is. Yeah, the policy thing, disregard that, let's check for updates. But as you can see here, there's a shit ton of updates and they take forever to fucking update Windows. That's something they have not even fixed with Windows 11, it takes for fucking ever to update. What should we do with Windows Server? I have it for 180 days, maybe longer. Let's figure out what happens after 180 days. It could be a fun one. But yeah, we can do a lot of fun things. See you all later, have an amazing day, and what should we do with this system? Bye-bye.